Welcome back, Dark Souls fans, to Let's Die Horribly in Dark Souls 3, and I just got the Avelyn. I finally figured out how to get it, where to get it from, and thankfully had the Silver Cat ring to get it with. So, there you go. That's how you get the Avelyn. I guess I might as well play around with it a bit. First, I'm just going to upgrade it, then afterwards mess around with it a little bit, because it seems like it could be pretty cool. And I have enough equip load to actually wield it. Alright, so let's roll with this for a little while. Unfortunately, one thing I actually was informed about is that the Avelyn is usually best with status inflicting bolts, but you can't use, I don't think you can use pine resins with it. I can check. I don't think you can. Let's see, where is the, one of these. Rotten pine resin, that's the one I care about. Okay. Let's see, if I two-hand it, no I can't. Yeah, so, unfortunately can't, and I can't buy any bolts that are poison or bleeding or whatever. I mean, if there is anything like that. So, bit of a shame, but we'll roll with it for a little while. Probably go back to the light crossbow soon enough, but let's go with this for a little while. And finish out the Grand Archives. Because there's that whole area over that kind of reminds me of Boletaria 1. Well, the first area of Boletaria. Once again, Demon Souls reference. I mean, I've said before, it's all Dark Souls and Bloodborne, except for the few Demon Souls references. And the few Demon Souls references are notably there. They exist. They're almost entirely Demon Souls, but they do exist. All right. Get the shortcut and beyond. There we go. Up to whatever's here. Not sure what that is. Oh, wait, no, yes I am. What am I thinking? I'm not even paying attention to anything I'm saying. Apparently not listening to myself. I'm a poor listener. Or at least I have no respect for what I have to say. Well, I guess no treasure off to the side. Always worth checking. So what exists here? Actually, I'm curious. I kind of did it. Oops. Huh. This is actually not the most bolt efficient. Like, in terms of single shot damage. Okay, that's not a good indicator. Huh. Whereas with Avelyn, it's... Oh, wow, yeah, that's way more powerful. Well, per bolt, less powerful. I would like to have something that would do, like, a bleed bolt on top of that? Man, if that was a bleeding bolt. But, I don't know, so, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay, kill them, kill them. Kill you. Burn loads of bolts. That's 100 souls every single time that happens. But hey, it's doing something, I guess. Huh. Ow. Oh crap, I can't deal with those things at range, can I? Would you stop hitting me? Okay, thanks, lock-on, for not working. And yes, I realize using Avelyn does use a lot of stamina. What? This is gonna take forever. Okay, so I've clearly got to rush down the spear wielders and probably experiment a bit less with crossbows. That's better. Hard to figure out. I don't know why I have a hard time figuring out range in 3D, but I really do. Okay, that's one knight, at least. Got rid of you. Alright, I don't care about the spear wielders. They are slow and do not move very much. Care about are you two annoyances. Like, that's how slow the spear wielders are. I can just heal up and I don't care. I really do not care. I gotta get this right sometime. What? I kicked you. And you're also gonna be hypercautious. Well, fine. Be that way. And then when you stop being hypercautious, I kill you. And thus justify your hypercaution. Well, another Titanite chunk. Certainly makes the Avelyn worth it. I did upgrade the Avelyn to plus 9 using up a bunch of my Titanite chunks, figuring I'm going to get a bunch more Titanite chunks, so whatever. It's no big deal. Great. I don't have to fight all three at once, do I? Game stop forcing me to fight multiple enemies at a time. Especially multiple giant enemies like those ones. And they're not coming? Oh, come on, I hit you to get you out of the way, or get you towards me. This is not gonna be fun. Especially because lock-on's failing. Shields. Well, I don't know how to deal with this. So I didn't want to kick. Game. Well, yeah, this is not happening. Okay. Got rid of those for this run, at least. Alright. Guess this is a boss fight. This run back's gonna be a pain in the butt. I can tell already, because this is bound to be a boss fight. I mean, unless there's some shortcut or bonfire or something I'm missing. Got a tiny chunk of an... What the heck? What, did I just get a Titanite chunk and an Ember for getting this far? Like, thank you? I suppose? Hmm. Okay, this is obviously a fight, so I'm just gonna... I'll be back in a sec. I might as well test the run back, because, well, I'm gonna have to anyway. Right, so the run back's not so bad. It looks like the knights tend to just buff up their weapons. They do follow me in here, though. Not that it matters, because I'm not summoning help.
Oh dear. Another dogged contender. Welcome, unkindled one. Purloiner of cinders. Mind you, the mantle of Lord interests me none. The fire-linking curse, the legacy of Lords, let it all fade into nothing. You've done quite enough. Now have your rest.
I see. Okay, this is interesting. I forgot to deep protection. Shoot. Well, risky move, but it worked out. Hmm. That's straightforward so far. No, don't get hit. Two or three swing combos. Ow. With some delays, so I guess they gotta be careful there. But not a great sense of accuracy. Right, and teleports. Oh, I'm out of stamina. Ow! Whoa! I want that sword! I want that sword right now! Please let that be the boss weapon! That is what my Titanite chunks have been saved for! But that's a faith-scaling weapon, faith-scaling greatsword that does that. Give me that sword! Assuming it has that as weapon art, that giant light shot thing, I want that.
Ugh. Dear brother,
of course we're only halfway through.
I'm on my way. My brother, unyielding sword of Lothric's prince. Rise if you would, for that is our curse.
So another 2 health bar boss. All right, kind of like the Abyss Watchers. Oh, what's... oh, shit. Oh, interesting. Okay, I don't think I'm going to survive this, but neat nonetheless. Ah, shoot. Darn it, that reload took that long? Okay, I'm gonna die here. I'm panicking. Oh, man, why does acid take forever to drink? Is that sorcery or miracle? Okay, I'm dead. I can't seem to get anything at this stage. Oh, wow, not dead. I mean, I'm dead, but, you know.
This spot marks our grave.
I had no choice. I was out of Vestas.
But you may rest here, too, if you like.
I hate running Vestas like that. It's like, wow, I got through the first try, and the second part, oh man, I know how this is going to go. This is going to be this long-ass death montage of me running through, and the first part's going to kill me 5 or 6 times before finally I get to the second part, and then I'm going to get to it tomorrow, because I'll probably get kind of tired or whatever, and that always happens. I get to it the next day, and then I do it in one go. That's what's going to happen here. Actually, you know what? I am going to change one thing. Go back to the light crossbow. The light crossbow is not quite as strong, but it's a bit more bolt efficient, and more importantly, it's going to be a lot easier to set up for any shots. Although Avelyn's not super slow, but I do not want to have pretty much any time. I think what I probably should do, actually, is in the second stage, go to the longsword, rather than Wolf Knight Greatsword. But anyway, to the run back. I wonder if I can run the whole way. Okay, got into the weapon charging. Yeah! Charge your weapons and... wow. Or charge at me, apparently. That's another option.
This spot
what?
Marks our grave.
I was falling.
But you may rest here too, if you like.
What did I tell you guys? What did I tell you? Wasn't gonna make it through the second time. Should probably limit myself to about 5 tries before just putting it down for a day. Man, I want that sword so bad. Man, I hope that's faith. I hope that uses faith. For the energy beams.
This spot marks our grave. But you may rest here too, if you like.
Okay, one more try, and then it's on to putting this down for a day. Well, I mean, putting this down, going to bed, getting back. Apparently that's a thing. Apparently you actually learn a lot while sleeping. Like, you go to bed, and your brain processes all the memories, and then the next day, you'll end up basically having learned the thing. Because your brain will have kind of gone over and over and over until it finally got internalized. So there's a lot of things, like for instance, the fire, where I've got to roll forward, and stuff like that will probably be internalized when I wake up tomorrow. That's usually what I found, at least, every single boss in this game that I've had problems with. It's just, I should only try it a handful of times, like half a dozen times, especially if I can get to phase two regularly.
This spot marks our grave. This spot marks our grave. But you may rest here too, if you like. Dear brother.
Okay, well, three tries after a good night's rest, but hey, yeah! That was interesting. That felt like the Throne Watcher Defender fight done right. I don't know if anyone's played Dark Souls 2, Yeah, one of the second to last fight, or third to last if you went through everything, you had two bosses that were pretty even. Like, one of them was slower and more agile. One of them was, slower and heavier. One of them was more agile. And basically, if either of them died, the other one would revive them. In this case, this is a better way of doing that concept, where you have one protecting the other, and the one being protected revives the one protecting. I like this. I like that setup. A little bit of an annoying surprise, but I think it works. So yeah, now for the standard boss stuff, assuming Firelink Shrine is still good, because that was the last one. That was the last Lord of Cinder. I don't know what's happening now. Okay, I guess I just have to place the ashes. I'll double check some stuff. But anyway, of course the first thing we do is check the soul. Soul of the Twin Princes. One of the twisted souls seeps in strength, used to acquire numerous souls or to transpose it to extract its true strength. The two princes rejected their duty to become Lords of Cinder and settled down far, far away to watch the fire fade from a distance. A curse makes their souls nearly inseparable. Okay. And what do we get? Do I get that sword? Do I get that light sword? I want that sword. I really want that sword badly. That's like, that is the sword I want. Please tell me that sword's there.
Sure.
Ooh, Lurian's greatsword. Yeah, oh, it's an ultra greatsword. Oh, it's pyromancy based. Okay. Ultra greatsword of Lurian, Prince Lothric's older brother. Cast in smoldering molten steel and stained black. Before Lurian embraced his brother's curse, he was a knight who single-handedly slayed the demon prince, but the victory eternally scorched his sword with flame. Skill as Flame of Lurian, lunge forward to transform smolder into flame and follow with strong attack to launch flame across ground. Actually, I think that's just the one that was the big shot of fire. That's Lothric's holy sword. Okay. Prince Lothric's straight sword, blessed by Emma with potent magic. Young Lothric was meant to be a champion and was expected to wield this platinum sword, but some things will remain distant dreams forever. Skill is Sacred Lothric Light. Assume stance to imbue sword with sacred light and use strong attack to release light together with a great thrust of the sword. I think this is the one I want. I'm not sure, but I'm pretty sure this is just the fire thing that Lurian kept using where it'd slam down and then a bunch of fire would pop up, and I think this is the one that's the big wave of light.
The eyes show a world that, what? I took all the
Yeah, more. Okay, whatever. Okay, so I guess I'll do some upgrades and testing and then be back in a sec. Okay, that's not quite what I wanted. I wanted to hold up, then drop down, then fire a wave of light. That's what the boss was doing. Didn't look like the other weapon was doing that either. I'm pretty sure that was just shoot the fire out. So that wasn't it either. And for those wondering, I'm not planning on doing New Game Plus until after I've done the DLC. I want to keep this character in New Game to do the DLC, and I'm probably going to film the DLC. So I'm not going to get that other sword for a while. Bit of a disappointment. But it's not a bad sword. I mean, it's still a long sword. I mean, shooting a beam of light is still shooting a beam of light. So I guess I'll roll with it for now. See how it goes. Yeah, it's not bad. It's just not exactly what I was looking for. Well, at least I got plenty of Titanite scales, so might as well upgrade it. Alright, well, I guess that's basically going to be it for this episode, so looks like next episode might be one of the last ones, either the last one or the second to last one, because I'm guessing I drop all the cinders on there, and then the ending starts, or the final boss fight, most likely, and then that'll probably be it. I wonder what the final boss fight is, anyway. Well, anyway, until then, thanks for watching, and then see you when we presumably finish this up.